Did you know that you can trademark the name Jesus? Well, you can, and that's what an Italian jeans company did back in 2007. So you have Jesus Jeans. They convinced the United States Patent Office to give them exclusive rights to the word Jesus, and now they're threatening to sue anyone who attempts to start an apparel line with that word in the title. So, should that be legal? A lot to discuss here. Joining me now for a fair and balanced debate, Fox News legal analyst Arthur Idala and trademark attorney Eric Menhart. Good morning to both of you, gentlemen.
Good morning, Gretchen.
All right.
Good morning.
I'm going to start with Eric because this is his specialty. I understand that it was a problem to actually get this trademark to begin with. There were a slew of countries, Turkey, China, Switzerland, Australia, Cuba, among others, who said you couldn't even do this original trademark. Why?
That's correct. There's a variety of rules, and different countries handle it differently. But primarily, the issue is that you don't want to basically allow anything that's immoral or scandalous, is the words that are used in the law. And different countries have different views as to what immoral or scandalous might be. Mm-hmm. And for example, Britain just determined that the word Jesus was, you know, effectively, it shouldn't be trademarked. It was immoral to have, you know, a major Christian figure be on a trademark. Mm-hmm. The United States and the European Union felt differently. And it's just a classic example of different viewpoints from different countries.
I guess, Arthur, one of the things that they feared would be advertisements like this for women in skimpy denim shorts under the slogan, "He who loves me follows me."
Right.
You got a problem with that?
Well, with the slogan, I mean, it's catchy, but do I think it should be really attached to the name Jesus? No, I don't. And look, the trademark laws are actually there to protect the consumer. So I'm just going to give you an example. Let's say they wanted to have Jesus soup. And it comes in a small can, and it's got red and white and a certain script. Everybody knows that's Campbell's soup. So when you go to reach on the what's that called? The shelf.
Shelf.
When you go to reach on the shelf in the supermarket to go grab the soup, and you see the red and white in the script, and you shouldn't even have to read the name. So that's really what the trademarks are for. There's no Jesus surfboard company out there that somebody, they're going to get confused for this Jesus surfboard versus that Jesus surfboard. So they're going to have a little bit of an uphill battle, I think, even though legally they're in the right because they have the trademark on the name Jesus.
There really are two issues here. Should Jesus even be trademarked, number one? And number two, now that it is in some countries, should other companies be able to use the name Jesus? Where do you fall on that, Eric?
Well, basically, that's exactly right. There are two issues. The first question is whether or not Jesus should be trademarked. Well, you know, you and I could sit here and we could talk for hours about whether or not it's immoral or not immoral, and different people had different viewpoints on that. It's as simple as that. Now, the United States has basically said, look, it's okay. You can do that.
But what about other companies? Do you think other companies should be able to use the name Jesus then, since somebody else already got it?
Well, assuming that the answer to number one is that you can, in fact, use Jesus, then as long as they have a valid and, you know, a trademark that they can use in commerce, and they are using in commerce, and they're otherwise following the law, then yes, they can preclude
Eric,
other
can
people
you,
from using
it. I mean, look, you're
it.
The expert here. Can you trademarks and win in court with something that's so broad? Can you trademark God? We're the only company that can use God. God jeans, God beer. God, I mean, can you do something that's so broad? Because it doesn't make sense to me.
Mm-hmm. Sure. And the answer to that question is that primarily you're talking about specific names on specific classes of goods. And so, for example, Jesus Jeans, theoretically, that company is not going to be able to go and preclude someone from using Jesus power equipment,
okay,
for example.
Right.
So the mere
fact
that
they're trying
on
to
jeans,
do here, Gretchen. My understanding is it's Jesus Jeans is going up against Jesus surfboard.
Okay.
So
much
apples and oranges.
I know it does seem like a wide array of difference there. I got to wrap it up there. Unfortunately, we could talk about this forever. Folks at home will continue to talk about it today. Arthur, Eric, thanks much.
Thank you. Have a great day.
Thank you.
Thank you.